that? It's been 3 years, man. I've been sitting right here waiting.
Too long.
Yeah, right, too long. Hey, Artie, give Steve a beer.
Thanks. Where is everybody? This used to be the big hangout.
Everybody split a long time since. The Bronx is dead.
Where'd they all go?
Upstate.
How come you didn't go?
Guess I'm lazy. Got the job at the post office. It's good. And I just don't like upstate. Fucking Poughkeepsie. Fucking Nanuet. Give me a break.
I like the Bronx.
That's right.
I like the Bronx too.
No, that does not compute.
What do you mean?
You were the first to go.
It just worked out that way. First I went in the army, and by the time I got out.
Yeah, I know, by the time you got out, time was tight, I had you by the balls, and you were on your way to who knows where. Anyway, why would you come back to the Bronx? The Bronx is dead.
There's still some areas that seem okay.
The Bronx is like one of those moon craters, man. Another couple of years, they're going to be sending astronauts out here. And guys from Houston, they'll be collecting rocks on Tremont Avenue. So how's Manhattan?
Manhattan's all right. Always a lot going on, a lot of excitement.
Uh-huh.
Good museums.
Museums. Yeah, they're electrifying. Then you got married.
Yeah.
What is she again?
A speech pathologist.
Speech pathologist? Oh, God, sounds fucking hideous. I live with a speech pathologist.
Vinny.
Yeah?
It's good to see you, man.
It's good to see you too, man. Time goes by, and everybody goes away. And you see what you had.
It's true.
You went out and stood on the corner, and everybody you ever knew was hanging there with you.
You know,
it was your neighborhood. It was something to be inside of. You could do anything you want because you knew the fucking rules.
You know, I think I left my wife.
What do you mean you think you left your wife?
Things haven't been good for a long time, man. I don't know why. There's nothing left that I enjoy.
I'm sorry.
Nothing happened. That's the really strange thing. I just told him. I felt like going. Coming to the Bronx, the old neighborhood, you know. And she said, all right. She said, okay. So I walked out.
Don't sound final to me. You can go back.
I don't think I can. I don't want to.
It's your life.
We're friends, baby. I know I didn't call you for 3 years. I know I didn't keep in touch much before that. But we're friends.
Yeah. Can let go of this.
Yeah,
I'm really happy.
I'm really happy.
Shut up.
Yeah.
So, look, Steve, how do you feel?
I'm alright.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Because when I got your call, I thought you might like to see some of the old crowd. So I phoned around a couple of folks should be here. Is that gonna be okay?
Who?
Ronnie.
Ronnie? Yeah, I'd like to see Ronnie. How's he doing?
Bad. Ronnie is always going bad. Try to kill himself.
No.
3 times.
Really?
Yeah. I make him come around. You know, he comes to my house sometimes. A few beers, whatever. Just to keep him from thinking.
What about?
I don't know. But whenever he starts thinking about it, he goes right down the tubes.
Who else?
Shirley. Shirley Dunbar.
She's coming in?
Yeah, she should be here now.
Bartender!
His name is Artie.
Artie! Give me a big glass of tequila.
What are you doing? What are you doing?
You don't know what you've done.
I guess not.
Shirley's coming here.
So?
You know she was my girlfriend.
She was your girlfriend when you were 17.
I haven't laid eyes on her since the day we broke up.
That was 30 years ago.
So?
So, what are you doing?
I'm trying to drink enough tequila to hold myself together.
What the hell are you talking about?
Don't you understand? That's why my marriage is breaking up. That's why I can't make it, can't sleep. I'm still in love with Shirley Dunbar.
You're kidding me!
I can't joke about it.
Oh, wow!
Whew! The day we broke up, I knew it wasn't over. I knew we'd have to see each other at least one more time. I was crying. I could see she didn't understand, didn't want to understand. The thing we had was big. I joined the service to get away. I couldn't stand seeing her walking down the street, knowing that she wasn't mine anymore. That's why I never came back to the Bronx. That's why I hardly ever called you, why I hardly ever called anybody from the old days. You were all a part of that time, the time Shirley and I were together. The only time in my life I ever really felt alive.
I am impressed. And here, I thought you were just another nice, shaky, shy guy looking for his roots. And you turned out to be a Heathcliff. I cannot live without my love. I cannot die without my soul. Welcome to the moon. Oh, shit. Steve. Ronnie's coming down the block. I know it's a lot to ask. Okay, but can you pull yourself together? It's just that Ronnie is real easy to get depressed, and he's always trying to do himself in. Can you hear me? Ah, fuck it.
See, what went you out booked his last speech? You know, he's there. You know, he'll get caught. So yeah. You're looking over a bit.
Yeah. Oh, fucking Heathcliff.
I mean, the bigger you go, the better.
Okay.
Your camera's over here.
Okay.
So you're working this direction, and suddenly, oh shit. You know what's going on with Vinny is, of course, you can't believe your fucking ears.
Right.
So everything, once you're rid of the book, it's just, I mean, all the good checks and reactions are. And there's not an attitude progression to follow. But it'll play. I don't mean shtick. If there's a moment or two where you take a swig of the beer when you're listening to something, but it can't be on anything because he has your attention the whole time. Mm-hmm. So it's hard, like in the last scene, I have a lot of very specific when they take a swig, you know, like I always do.
Yeah.
But here, you know, it's too, you know, you're too much into it. And Stephen goes places that is. Benny, I am impressed, fucking Heathcliff. When you see Ronnie coming, look out center.
Okay.
No, look out there. Left, that's where he came from. Like you're looking through a window.
Okay.